Polish-American Connection on BCTV is supported by the Polish-American Heritage Association.
Greetings and welcome. This is your Polish-American Connection TV program, and I'm the host and producer, Tom Gajewski. I'd like to welcome you to the program. October is Polish Heritage Month, and because of that, we thought we'd come up with a special theme for tonight's program, and the theme is something that not only Polish people like, but a lot of other people like it because it's good time, good feeling stuff, and that's polka music. And we're going to be talking about that in just a little while. And we're also going to be talking about the local polka DJ icons that go way back into the 1950s. So I think it'll be an interesting show. And we'd like to invite you to participate because my guest has put a lot of time into researching this. And I know some of it. But I'm sure there's a lot that we don't know. So if you know something that we don't know and you want to make a contribution to the show, please call us. I'd like to say congratulations to Marilyn Vlaszewski, Sandy Hummel, Tony Wade, and Marianne Becker from the Polish American Heritage Association on the 25th anniversary, and all the members on the 25th anniversary of the Polish American Heritage Association. Also like to thank and congratulate Nadine Lucky and her committee for all that they did to put together the 25th anniversary picnic, and also her husband Dan, who was the grill man that day and did a great job, didn't burn any burgers that I know of. And also Ann Arnold and Marilyn Vlaszewski for their work in putting together a nice picture display that was displayed at the picnic. And a lot of people enjoyed that too because it brought back a lot of memories of what happened with Polish American heritage over the years. Also like to thank Marianne Zerkowski because she talked about what we did with the Polish American Cultural Center, and that was an idea that originally came from Helen Kabaki, and the Polish American Heritage Association, after a number of years, made that a reality. A couple of reminders, this is a two-way program. If you want to call in with a question or comment, please do that at 610-378-0426. The only thing we ask is make your comment or ask your question and then give our guest or me an opportunity to answer. The other thing is you may want to get some paper and pencil because at the end of the program we have a number of events that we're going to be announcing. And with that, I'd like to introduce our special guest tonight. His name is Larry Soltys, but he's better known as Shotgun Louie in the polka world anyway. He's been involved with polkas and polka music for a long time, and you'll see that he knows what he's talking about. And he also was a contributing writer for Loose Ends. And I have to ask you this, too. You say that we have one of the top shows on BCTV that's aired on YouTube.
Yeah, according to a friend of mine who gets into this stuff all the time, and that he told me the last he seen it last night that we were 16 hits away from 2,000 hits on YouTube. Wow. On the show we did back in November on East Reading and that.
Wow, very good.
I must have caught everybody up I know in the world to watch that show on YouTube.
And we also want to thank Walter Kay, too, because on Sundays he promotes the show for us, and so we appreciate that. So, Larry, you brought some pictures here of some of these polka icons with you, so you want to get started with that?
Okay. Okay, this first picture here is Jack Wallace and Kaz. At WRW, believe it or not, I talked to Marianne Viglinski, Jack's wife, this morning. She lives in Boca Raton. And I talked to Kasia Milanik last night. I have to thank both, and Kasia Milanik, it was Pawn Stefan's sister, thank both of them for a lot of the information they gave me. I thought Jack started at WRW, but it turns out he originally was at WHUM. Hmm. I knew he was down there because I had gone down there one time portraying a little fat guy in a red suit at Christmas time. So I was trying to figure out when this happened and that. But according to what Mary Ann said, it was around 1966 that Jack started off at WRIW.
Oh, I just want to interject one thing, and that's that, and we don't have a picture of this individual, but there is an individual by the name of C.J. Laporte, who apparently was involved with polka music even before that. And he is now 91 years old and still in good health from what I understand. Don't know much about him, but I know that he was associated with, WEEU for a number of years.
You know, I don't remember the name, but I can remember always in the beginning of the show, they used to say, it's polka time. Mm-hmm. But so that's what his name was. I was too little and young and to remember that. You know, somebody like you, Tom,
yeah,
you'd
right.
remember that,
of,
you know.
I'm a lot older. Right.
Okay.
Go ahead, please.
Next picture is a picture of Jack Wallace. His right name was John Viglinski. That was taken at WRW. He was there up until, I think his wife said, 1990 when he moved to Florida and that. But he was known as, his show was called Captain Jack's Flight 1340 Polka Show. Mm. Jack was a pilot. He had his own license and that. So that's how they came up with that name and that. But like I said, he's the one I remembered from many times. Jack Wallace, he ran a lot of bus trips down to the shore. He ran a lot of polka dances. As a matter of fact, the one time at St. Mary's was one of the few times at St. Mary's that he had Happy Louie there. Mm. He had 500 people in that place. Mm. They had the music upstairs and downstairs. And I remember I sold the most tickets. I tried like crazy, and I ended up selling 100 out of them 500 tickets for him. But
even going back to the 50s, I think Kaz was involved in organizing one of the first polkas. That's what he
yeah, called. I think something at the Falcons and whatnot.
Yeah, but anyway.
Okay. Next one we have here. This was Jack Wallace with his band. This was the first job he ever did. I'm not sure what year it was. It was down at St. Mary's. The girl in the middle was his wife, Mary Ann, and back then it was just called Jack Wallace Polka Band. The next picture, I think, there's a picture of him. That's Mary Ann's right next to him. I don't know who the other two young ladies were, but that was Jack Wallace back in the early days. I would say back in when he had hair. This was the picture taken at that dance. As you can see up on the balcony, there was a sign there, good luck, Jack Wallace and the band. And these are all the people that are there dancing in that. And then there's another picture taken from the balcony looking down at the band. You can see all the people that were there. It was a nice time at it.
And of course, that's the Polish Falcons.
No, that's St. Mary's Hall.
Oh, was it? Okay.
That was St. Mary's Hall.
Okay.
Yeah, that was St. Mary's Hall. Then he changed his name to the Polka Spirit. His brother, Mickey Viglinski, that's him on the accordion there. And Frankie Jezik is on the saxophone there. And I don't remember what the other two guys were. I'm not sure where that one was. That could have been at the Falcons because it's a smaller stage in that.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next one, that was when he got his band together. They called him the Troubadours.
Mm.
And on the left there, that's Frankie Jezik. Next to him with the accordion is Mickey Viglinski, then Jack Waller, Jack Viglinski. Believe it or not, that guy on the guitar there, I'm sure a lot of people know him. That's Mark Abrams.
Mm.
Wow. And like I said, the trumpet guy, I don't know what the trumpet guy was, what his name was. Now, that was the last picture I know taken of Jack. That was taken for our 50th class reunion.
By the way, Mark Abrams is Mark
Abramovich. Yeah.
Yes.
I always kid him about that when I see him.
I'm working on trying to get him to come on a show here to talk about his career, too.
As a matter of fact, he told me that. He says, you tell Tom, I won't go on that show unless I have you to back me up because you can talk. Like I said, this picture was taken for our 50th class reunion. That would have been 2013, I guess. On the left there is my cousin, Danny Gadachik. That's Jack Wallace in the middle, and then me. Jack had passed away like almost, I guess, less than 3 weeks after that picture was taken.
Mm.
As a matter of fact, we didn't even know if he was going to make it up. And he had a lot of problems, heart problems and whatnot.
Mm.
Okay, I think that's the end of Jack's pictures. Okay, there's Kaz.
Mm.
Now, that picture was taken, believe it or not, at WREW.
Mm.
Now, he was there for a while back and forth with Jack, but then he went out on his own. He went to WEEU. And I don't know what the name of his show was originally, but the last show was called Kaz German Bavarian Alpine Polka Show.
Mm-hmm.
Now, he just passed away last July, 2016 of July. And I guess his daughter, Karen, is doing a show now.
Yes.
On WEU.
Sunday mornings, right.
Now, there's a picture of Kaz with his WEU shirt on, his coat. I don't know where that picture was taken at.
And besides polka music, he did a lot with German music.
Yes. Well, you see in another picture. Oh, yeah, he mainly was mixed up a lot of the... His favorite band was Jimmy Sturr.
Mm-hmm.
Jimmy Sturr, Jimmy Sturr was his buddy in that. As a matter of fact, I think we'll be coming up on it. Okay, I got hired them. That's Kaz and his band. We had open house over at Rockwell, which used to be textile.
Mm-hmm.
We had a big open house there, and we hired Kaz... I guess he was called the Bavarian Band at that time. That was him and his band out there playing outside on the grounds of Rockwell. And I'm not sure what year. That was probably back in the 1980s. I'm not exactly sure. Let's see here. Okay, there's Kaz with Pat Garrett, believe it or not.
Okay.
Now people are going to say, why do you have Pat Garrett with Kaz? I said, well, the reason was Pat Garrett wanted to run a poker show up at his amphitheater. He had all these country singers and everything. He wanted to have a poker show. So I hooked him up with Kaz. And believe it or not, Kaz ended up getting Jimmy Sturr up at the amphitheater. And here's an unusual picture. Here's the stage here. To the left there, the Jimmy Sturr poker band. And to the right is all the people dancing on a stage. Pat said he thinks that's the first and only time he ever had people dancing on that stage up there.
And Pat Garrett had some really top talent over the years.
Oh, yeah,
B.J. Thomas, I remember.
Oh, yeah. I worked up at Pat Garrett's, I don't know how many years. Towards the end, I did backstage security. And you won't believe how many people I met up there. But I always said it wasn't a job. It was a privilege. It was a privilege. And the one person I always kid people that I babysitted up there, believe it or not, was Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift, when she first started, up at Pat Garrett's. And I used to keep an eye on her backstage before she went up on stage. She was only about 11, 12 years old at that time. That was a party up at Pat Garrett's at a Christmas party. That's yours truly in the red white outfit. That's Jan Majewski.
Oh, from Giorgio Food.
Giorgio Food. He used to be the president of Giorgio Food, and there's Kaz there and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
Kaz was giving me a salute there. Here's a picture of that. I guess it's sort of like a postcard. His band then was Kaz and the Mischief Makers. Mm-hmm. You remember them? They played a lot back in the 50s and 60s. If you didn't get Kaz and the Mischief Makers, you got the Polka Dots or you got Eddie W. Those are the three bands that everybody had at their weddings back in them days. I'm not sure where International Polka Festival. That might have been up at Hunter Mountain because he was quite big up at Hunter Mountain.
By the way, I remember, and I'm sure you remember this too, if you walked from St. Mary's on a Sunday morning, if you walked down 12th Street and walked at, like to Muhlenberg or walked
Cotton
up
Street.
Chestnut, up Cotton Street, if there was one house playing polka music, you only had to walk one or maybe two houses more, and then there would be the same show. So you could listen to it all the way home.
Yeah, and the best part was you could smell all that Polish kabasi and the galunkies cooking and whatnot.
And kishka.
Kishka, yeah.
Yeah.
And halushki.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see what we have next here. Oh, that was a picture I had taken with me and Kaz. That was up the Liederkranz. I think that was 2 years ago. Here up there, they had given him some kind of award or whatnot. As you can see, his health was deteriorating. You can see in that picture there. I believe that's less than a year before he passed away.
By the way, his real name was Kazimierz Wolkiewicz.
Yep, Kazimierz Wolkiewicz. He was born in Austria, but he was Polish.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess he had the Austrian in it. That's how he got into the Alpine
German music
and that and whatnot. But he was always after me. A lot of times he had given me tickets for different stuff, like Sunnybrook. He always wanted me to go up that Hunter's Mountain, but I was never much of a person to drive that much. Let's see, where are we at here? Oh, God, we're halfway through already. We got plenty of time. Okay, let's see what we got next here. Okay, there's Pon Stefan. His right name was Stephen Milanek. He originally started up in Allentown with a guy you see quite a bit around nowadays called Happy Jack. They had a show up in Allentown. And then...
grew up on Cotton Street, by the
way. Grew up on Cotton Street.
1100 block.
1100 block Cotton Street. And after Jack retired, I was going to say, Jack retired in, I think, 1990. Then who was it that took over for a while? Smoke? No. First Jack's son, Christopher. He ran the show for about a year.
And then Mark Smokowitz.
Mark Smokowitz. But Mark didn't have many records because Jack took all that with him. So the way I understand, Steve always told me that Mark used to ask him to come down and help him out. Mm-hmm. And then eventually he took over the show on that.
Mm-hmm.
That was at the controls at WRW. I know who that guy is there. I don't know how many times, I can't count, I don't got enough of fingers, how many times I did like you did. Mm-hmm. I answered the phone there for Pon Stefan.
Mm-hmm.
As a matter of fact, when Pon Stefan died and Walter K took over, I don't know how many times I answered that phone and said, Pon Stefan Polka, Walter K Polka Show. I was so used to it and whatnot. But I wasn't the only one. Like you said, you did it, but
mm-hmm.
Cindy Koretsky,
mm-hmm.
me, and Walt Kazimierzak, mm-hmm. who's known as Walter K now, we all, different times, you know, did the job of answering the phone.
Sure.
We always liked that picture of Walter K there because, as a matter of fact, Terry Frankowiak put it in the magazine on the front cover the one time. I forget what it was for, but he said that's his Bart Simpson haircut.
I don't know if he'll appreciate that.
Oh, he thought it was pretty fun. Whoops, let me get back here. I mean, how did that get so far ahead here? Okay, here we go. Here's Davy Korch.
Mm-hmm.
Davy Korch took care of the controls. Every time, back in the old days, Lord Kazazak and his wife and Pon Stefan, they'd like to go out to that Seven Springs out there
mm-hmm.
Near Pittsburgh. So Davy Korch knew how to take care of the controls. So Davy used to take care of the controls, and I used to answer the phone for Davy. We did it, I don't know, maybe once a year for a couple of years and that.
And Dave had his own band. I don't know if he still plays anymore, but...
Yeah, well, I forget. What was the name of that band?
I can't remember, but for quite a few years.
Yep. I just can't remember what it was now. There's my nephew, Jonathan Lumnichuk. They knew him as Yashu. He was on... Steve's show a couple of times,
mm-hmm.
as a matter of fact, and in later years, he was on with Walt and John Butchop.
Mm-hmm.
It was the three of them.
Yeah, John did it for a while.
Yeah, John Butchop did it for quite a while. This picture was taken. Here's Pat Garrett there.
Mm-hmm.
It's Pat Garrett. Next to him in the black and white is me, then Pon Stefan, then Walt Decay, and that was the Polka Family Band. I was sort of proud of that because I hired those guys 7 years in a row. They played at St. Mary's.
Mm.
And 7 years in a row, we were sold out.
Mm.
As a matter of fact, I had people come to the door, some of these young Polish guys. They said, we'll stand at the bar. I sold 15, 20 tickets. They stood there at the bar all day because they just wanted to come in and hear that band. Now, this was taken up at Flying Hills. That's Pon Stefan there,
mm-hmm.
Walter K and me, towards the left-hand...
Not Walter K, that's Kaz.
Don't mind me. You know what I said? I said, that's Pon Stefan, Kaz, and Walter K. That's me.
Yeah.
That's me. In the left-hand corner up top here, you can see that was the old stand we used to buy the tickets up here at Flying Hills.
Mm-hmm.
I threw a couple of these in because of what... That was one of the big dances that it was so big that they actually had a beer truck up there. It was me and Pon Stefan. They sold it at the bar area to the left, but they also... had that truck up there.
Of course, Polish Falcons had dances, St. Casimir's had dances.
Oh, yeah. But these were the picnics up here at Flying Hills.
Yes.
I mean, there was a time up at Flying Hills that they had a picnic every week, and Little Andy Polka Band played every week.
Well, some Sundays there were two picnics, Polish picnics on the same day.
Yeah, that was bad because, you know, you didn't know which...
Got 5 minutes.
Okay, we're just about done here. Okay, this picture here was taken at the one day picnic up there. That's me, Walter K, Pon Stefan. And that's Eddie Blazonczyk,
mm-hmm.
big name in poker business. Eddie B, he was known as. Here's another one taken out there. That's Walter K. That character there in a white shirt was a guy that used to always call the station Hollywood Harry. You
mm-hmm.
remember that?
I
that's
do.
Hollywood Harry, mm-hmm. me, and Pon Stefan. Okay, this is a Terry made these shirts up and had a picture of me and Steve on it, and we announced it on a show. Anybody that comes up to the picnic wearing one of those shirts, they would get $5 in them loose end food stamps. So there was 12 of them that showed up. It is my mother, there is John Bruchock. And that's a picture of the shirt closer. I took that last night. It said, listen to Shotgun Louie on the Pond Stefan Polka Show and win this fabulous shirt. Listen to Pond Stefan Polka Show Sundays, 9:15 a.m. to noon on WRW 1340. And I guess he was transmitting up in Allentown then, I guess, 1390. But I seen that Terry had that there and win this fabulous shirt. I said, oh, my God. Well, it's amazing how many of those shirts went out. I think there's... Okay, that was a pretty well-known polka people. That was Wicked Wanda and her daughter, Laura. Anybody who went to polka dances knew them. That picture was taken already at the... Also, we sold the tickets. There's Mike Lenarczak there. And next to him is Joey Zawanguski. Those were the Maluzzi sisters. There was a bunch of Maluzzi kids. That's at the... And this one here was taken up. That was one of Terry's shirts there. It said Polish American, proud of it. That was my cousin John and Joni Minorik.
Do we only have 3 minutes left in the show? Okay.
Okay, no, I just got one. I just want to get this
quick,
one in.
Quick.
That's
quick,
the last
quick.
One there. That's John Bruchock with his wife Sally, Walter K. John Bruchock was the one with Walter K for many, many years. Okay. And now it's Gene Rockel.
Right.
That's it.
Thanks very much. Let's get on to our events at the end of the show. First of all, happy 25th anniversary again to the Polish American Heritage Association. From the founders, yours truly, Dolores Taras and Marianne Zerkowski. Celebrate Polish American Heritage Month. Always be proud to be Polish. October is Polish American Heritage Month. The picnic on September 9th is over. But the Pulaski Day Parade, by the way, congratulations to Marilyn Blaszewski and Polish American Heritage. They had about 30 people down there from Reading, and you can see it on YouTube, and it's about 40, and go to YouTube, and then you go to the Pulaski Day Parade, Philadelphia. Polish American Heritage Cultural Center at the Goggle Works, 5th floor, 2nd and Washington Streets, open Saturday and Sunday, noon to 4. Learn about your heritage. This is an important one coming up, Southern Junior High School. We're going to have a reunion of all classes. So we'd like to have you please take advantage of that. You can call myself on that at 610-698-8731. That's on Saturday, October 21st. Polish American Heritage Association respectfully invites you to their 25th anniversary mass at St. Mary's, 12th and Spruce. And that's on Sunday, October 15th at 10:30. Polish American Heritage Association will have a light lunch after the Mass, a meet and greet downstairs. That's on the 15th, following the Mass at 10:30 at St. Mary's downstairs. Polish American Heritage Association has their meeting. This is a change. We don't have it this time. It's not at the Goggle Works. It's at St. Mary's, and it will start approximately 1:30 after the light lunch and meet and greet. Polish American Heritage Association has their meeting at 1:30, as I said. Polish American Heritage Association has a new scholarship program. Students with a minimum of 25% Polish ancestry, and you can get applications starting in November from the high school guidance counselor. You can call Sandy Hummel, Vice President of Polish American Heritage, at 610-207-7065. And she's also reachable by email at sahummel@ptd.net. Polish t-shirts and novelty buttons available at Christina's Kitchen in the Fairgrounds Market. Also lots of good food. Paul Drzba wrote 3 books. Carsonia Park, it's an interesting one. I'm reading it now. Pandora Park, The Forgotten Trailer Park, and Never Sink Mountain. And they're available at the Berks History Center, the Pagoda Gift Shop, and on eBay. And then the Carsonia book is also available at Jake's of Mount Penn. Polish American Connection TV show, the first Tuesday of the month at 7:30. And that's on Comcast Channel 15, Service Electric Channel 19. And it's rebroadcast this coming Friday at 1:30, next Monday at 10:30, and next Tuesday at 3:30 p.m. We'd like to say thank you to Larry Soltys for a good job here today, and also like to thank all of you, and thank you for your support over the years. We just celebrated our anniversary last month, and we'd like to say until next time, the first Tuesday of November, which will be November 7th at 7:30 p.m., thank you, take care, God bless, and always be proud to be Polish.
Polish-American Connection on BCTV is supported by the Polish-American Heritage Association.